Intel sent me a little package last week, the Lenovo Yoga 9i. But don't fret, I know just a couple months ago, LG sent me this laptop. You have Lenovo, LG, Lenovo, LG. Well, to be honest with you, I'm not here to talk about either laptop. The Lenovo is only a way for me to talk about Intel's new 11th Gen Core processor with the Intel Iris Xe graphics. You can only find these in certified Intel Evo Series laptops, including the Lenovo, including the new LG Gram, and including many others, as well as one of my other favorite laptops of all time, the Dell XPS. I've left links for you to learn more and check out the full lineup of laptops in the Intel Evo series, but only until after this video. Because in this video, not only are we going to be discussing the improvements of the Intel 11th Gen Tiger Lake CPU, but I'm also going to be putting their technological claims to the test with the Lenovo. Let's see if it can handle the type of work we do every day as software engineers, and maybe some work I do as a content creator to test out the highly praised Intel Iris Xe graphics. Under Intel's overall CPU lineup, you have two different categories. You'll see their desktop CPUs, which what you'll find in a desktop computer tower, and then you have their mobile CPUs, what you'll find in these thin and light laptops, and what we will be talking about today. And I wanted to give my take at the end of this video. The video would make much more sense to progress that way, for you to see how it performs under my workflow of coding, 4K video editing, and gaming, but I just can't help myself. My overall impression of the new Intel chip, well, it surprised me. I did not expect it to perform as well as it did. And I'm talking from a CPU and a GPU standpoint. They said it had greater than 20% CPU performance improvement. They said it had 2 times the graphics performance with the new Xe graphics architecture. And they said that it had 5 times the AI performance. While I did not test out the AI performance in today's video, I'm only led to believe that to be true. Because based on what I've seen today and the benchmarks I've ran, the former two hold up. We are seeing a 20% CPU performance improvement over their 10th gen, and we are seeing over 2 times the graphics performance in a gaming situation. And as interesting as all that sounds, it being this much better than its previous version, it doesn't mean anything if you don't have a practical understanding of what to expect. So instead of getting stuck on the numbers, I wanted to ensure that I could take this laptop on trips or to a communal workspace and get my work done. That work includes coding, video editing, and a little bit of play gaming. Let's code. I need to set up a MERN application from a new coding project, Project Engagement. I mentioned that in a previous video about my coding plans for this year. So let's do it. All I'm really doing here is familiarizing myself with the MERN stack thanks to y'all's recommendation on my previous video when I asked y'all what we should build Project Engagement with. And the MERN stack was by far the most popular choice. I love learning new things, so that's what we decided to go with. This wasn't the most CPU intensive work, but it was real work, something I needed to get done. And I'm happy to say the laptop allowed me to complete it flawlessly. Something Intel won't let you go without knowing is their major improvement made to their CPU's integrated graphics known as Intel Iris Xe. I have 2 ways I want to test this out. The first being video editing. And unfortunately for this laptop, I record, render, and export all my video in 4K. There are a couple things I want to see here. I just dropped 75 gigabytes of 4K footage into Premiere Pro on this laptop. I want to see how long it takes until I can actually start editing this video. And then I want to see how long it takes to fully generate all of the files. And conveniently enough, in real time, we can see that it took about 15 seconds until I was able to start editing the video. But you're going to have to take my word on how long it took to generate the files, which was just under a minute. For 75 gigabytes of 4K footage, that's pretty good. But most importantly, I want to see how it performs. I don't do that much heavy editing, but I have run into the problem with past computers where it would stutter. 4K footage, 1080p footage, it wouldn't matter. I would have to set the quality down to at most 1/2, which I want to see playback at full resolution. This doesn't seem to have any problems doing just that. and it's only sitting at 50% GPU usage. And by GPU, I mean integrated graphics. Call me easygoing, but as long as it can do that, I'm satisfied. If it can do that, it can do anything else that I need it to do. Work is done. Now let's take a break with some Overwatch. Let me tell you what we're working with. So in Overwatch, I'm running all low settings. It seems to be what most pros prefer. And while this is a 4K 60Hz panel, I decided to take the limit off the FPS so we could see how it performs, and I am running it at 1920 by 1080 to give it a fair shake. And I was on the edge of the map for most of that, so here it is in the midst of battle. You can see how the FPS fluctuates, but still maintains a solid frame rate considering the fact, and you have to remember this, there is no dedicated graphics card. What you see here is the product of Intel's Iris Xe integrated graphics on their 11th gen CPU. I know I already gave you my thoughts on the processor at the beginning of this video, but I'm so impressed with the new Intel 11th gen processors that I almost feel bad. I recommended a laptop back in November, the LG Gram. Still a great laptop, but with the recent announcement of the Intel Evo Series laptops and the new LG Gram just now being added to the lineup.
I had to add it. It's only right.
Thank you all for watching. If you could do me a favor, check out the new Intel Evo Series laptops by clicking the link in the top of the description. And thank you to Intel for sponsoring this video. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see y'all next week. Now, I know I said the idea for this video was to inform you about the 11th gen Intel processor and not the laptop, but I needed to repackage it to show you how Lenovo packaged this laptop and how it arrived to my doorstep. Within a shipping box was a white box. Within a white box was the laptop box. And check out this laptop box. Now, I don't know if that was special packaging for me or if Lenovo packages all of their laptops like that. But I am a sucker for good packaging, and that is good packaging.